save time, the way I'm making these clips is I'll let the recording go for the full session. What Justin TV does then is he'll take sections of the entire taping and leave it in the archive. Later I would go into the archive and select like 9 to 10 minute segments, make my clips and post them on the archive section there. Kind of number them from starting like 001 through out. And those same clips I'm posting them up on YouTube also. And I'm going to try to label them best I can. For instance, this particular clip, if it comes out, I will label it Paws of 008 or 009, something like that. Question, just post it there and I'll try to answer it on one of the videos. I'm not always looking back there to see, well, I'm referring to my computer to see what people are posting. And I try not to touch the mouse or keyboard once I have my hands full of clay. Good thing to do also is use a caliper to take your measurements. I like using this one here, though you can use others. They're almost the same size. Here we go. Put some away here. Kind of a slope here. This is to the 90 degrees, so we kind of apply the same slope. Let me see, where did it start? Right there. Right there. Right about there. It's just constant, slight changes, tweaking it, subtle changes. And I notice this one's pointing forward, this one is kind of turning in, which is not correct. Dogs, for the most part, either point forward or slightly outward. So I need to make that correction. I'm going to lower the music to tad so you guys get up. Pick up this better. There. Okay. Pointing in this direction. More sunken in than this here, though I'm not sure if it's correct. Most likely this one, because it's more of a 90 degree. This one is sloping down, so if it's correct this here. rest of this year. And what I do, I just kind of scribe it, and let me know how deep I need to go. At that point, I'll just remove enough clay till I come to the end of my scribe. Possibly use the other side as my reference, trying to make this as symmetrical as possible. Otherwise, you'll have a dog with two left feet or two left paws. Hey, Alberto, if you're out there, why don't you call in so you and I could talk on Skype? Now I'm going to use my alcohol torch right now to kind of warm this side up so it'll allow me to use my fingers to mold and get the feel for what this side looks like or feels like. Here, where did you go, little torch? Here we go. That's not good. And this is the alcohol torch. It's used in the jewelry industry, and what's in here is denatured alcohol. And if you have one of these here, never put any other kind of alcohol in here, or solvent, fuel. If you put something hotter than what denatured alcohol burns, you will end up melting this piece here and causing a fire. And this whole piece is made of some kind of plastic. The top is a metal, so if the metal generates too much heat, it'll melt the cap. The cap will eventually get to the plastic here, and you're in for a world of problems. And here, I'll just fill up to the recommended fill line here. Once in a while, your wick here will get smaller, so you have to adjust it. What I do, I grab this end here and just twist. As I twist, I move forward, push it in, so I expose more of the wick. That's about right. I'm more like the